Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Today we have a new video for Marvel Future Fight. In today's video we are going to talk a little bit of the story missions and we are going to help you with if you have any problem with. And I will announce the winners from the previous giveaway. First, the winners of the previous giveaway are those guys over here. We had only 6 participations. I was going to give 10 codes, but as I see over here, they really, those guys, basically there are not many guys that really want free diamond, so yeah, I don't really have problem with that. I'm really happy with the guys that already participated. If you are struggling, you can just comment down below in the comment. And I will help you with how you participate. You will find a link down below in the description of the link of how to participate. All you have to do is just join in the entries that I have there, and it is just that. You don't have to do anything else. So I'm going to start a mini series of the story missions. I will start with the Dimension class, campaign and alternate mode. If you are already familiar with the campaign mode, just skip this part and go a little bit further. If you are not and you are free and you have and you are struggling with, stay with me right now. So I will skip the part of the story mission. I will just have it here for you know, informational purposes. If you're if you want to see what are the you know, the conversations here, you may be interested in something like that. Yeah, they restarted those conversations here with Stark and Jocasta. So what we have to do is try and upgrade every single character that it give us, and we have a specific box as a reward as we progress further. All we have to do is upgrade our Iron Man, Captain America and Black Widow, and what we have to do is just keep going with them. It is quite normal and easy. If you ask me if it is worth to do it every single time for the box, yeah, I don't think so. But yeah, once, at least just do it. You will never know what you are going to get. So as you see over here, it is quite easy to do it. You don't need any crazy knowledge. So yeah. We got our first reward and we keep going. So as you see over here, we have a notification of what we can do with our characters. We are able to use our uniforms, as you see over here. If we want to unlock our skill types, you see over here the requirements, 1-3, 2-3, 3-3, and as it goes on. This will take some time, so if you really want to skip that, just get the guide down below in the description. I have the specific times for it, okay? So you don't have any problem get guidance, and if you are struggling with the same with a single story mission. So as you see here, it is quite easy. All you have to do is go in the specific spot, grab them all together and kill them all together. I really like this kill of Captain America. Excellent, we are keep going. We don't have any ISO set. I don't think our cards are active over here, so yeah, that is why I think it is the same also for you guys. You can use whoever you want and you like from those kind of characters. There isn't something special. All you have to do is kill every single monster you have here and just progress further. It is quite easy for the beginning of the missions. I don't think you will have any problem. The difficulties we have, I think in this one, it is after we progress a little bit further. When we have, we need the specific skills like Black Widow skills and stuff. We will see them as we continue. Excellent. 1-2 is finished. And we progress further. Yeah, it's too late. Here will be soon. I have stolen nothing from you. Excellent. He has gone. Jocasta starting right away, Captain. Okay, and this is it, right? We are already in the 10%. So all you have to do is, as I told you, to go here at the edge, bring them all together and kill them all together. You don't have to run all over and try to shoot the enemies. They just appear here and just kill them, okay? And just progress further. I'm going to skip those. I don't think we will need them from now on. All the story it is quite the same. Okay, 1-3 has been also done. So for someone that so we unlocked our skills, the first skills of our characters. As you saw over here, we are able to choose what exactly our first skill will do. Okay, what it does right now, it is doing this one. It shows you also from the previous skill window. And it can be done like this one, so send two flames and those, and stun and electrify the targets. I will choose this one, and I'm going to use also the skills for the rest of the characters. Okay, I'm going to freeze them, and this one, paralyze and poison. I am going to choose this one. So we progress further. As you see, it isn't something difficult to do. All you have to do is just go here. Yeah, sometimes it is a little bit hard. Try to focus and you will do it easily. Those are the strangles that I was talking about. All you have to do is just keep going. So all you have to do is just go here. Okay, try to avoid those here, because you will die easily. All you have to do is start after those are finished. So the only thing that you have to be careful of here, it is the air that they have. They open the air and they push you back. All you have to do is just go from the above and stick at the edges. This will help you not to die. Also this one, just go close to it, and when it sit down, just leave from close to it, because they are exploding and it does a lot of damage. This one also. As you see, it is quite easy. Don't try to kill them. You are able to kill them, but there is no point. So here you are able just to sit here and let the skills recover, or you just go also again there and kill it. It isn't something special. Your fifth skill, it is quite strong, so yeah. 2-1 has been done, and we are keep going. As you see, it is quite easy, I told you. So here we have also the air. All you have to do is just do it with one time, and also just keep here until it is done, and after that just go here and go in the next stage. So here, as I told you, with those kind of robots, go close to them. Don't try to stick into the edges, because they might keep you there, and they might kill you. You don't have enough HP to handle both of those. It is quite easy, as you see over here. You don't have to do anything, just stand there, and also here just try to have everything close by, and you are able to kill them easily, so don't worry. Okay, as you see over here, it was quite easy. The next one is Luke Cage, that as you see over here, he is also quite easy. It is done, okay. All you have to do is just go and keep going. Here you don't have to kill those, but it is quite good to do it. So here, just go and keep going like here. The same goes for here, you don't have to kill them, but they will keep hitting you and they won't help you go further easily. So here you have to keep going also here, and stick here at the edge. Now keep going. So the skill that we changed, it was this one, the first one. We haven't gone back to change any other skills yet, but some of them are already unlocked. We don't need them, you don't need them, believe me, okay? All you have to do is just keep doing what I do, and it will be easier for you. So don't worry. You see, also Iron Man said Dicey. Try not to stick close to them. Try to be in the middle, and don't stuck on the edges, because you will be eliminated. And try to stick them all together. This will be easier for you also. Okay, that was also the 2.2, sorry. We are keep going. You are getting a lot of materials, as you see over here, biometrics to upgrade your characters, or if you don't have them, to upgrade them. I think in the story mission, if I am right, they are already giving you free those characters, so all you have to do is just upgrade them. The same goes for here. All you have to do is go from here. And keep going. Okay. So here you have to change because they are immune to the physical attacks, and Captain America is only hitting with physical attacks with this kind of uniform. Here, as I told you, don't try to stick close because you will die. Some of them have a small radius, some of them has big radius, so be careful not to stay close to those who has a big radius. It will be painful for you, believe me. From my point of view, those kind of uniforms, I really liked them, but I was hoping that they will add some more features, like to change the skills from the story missions. So, for an example, if we change the skills from here, to be able to to keep them. I was waiting for something like that to happen, but they didn't do it, so yeah. I was a little bit of disappointed with this one, but yeah, I really think that it is quite a big of a job to do it, because yeah, try to do it for 200 and something characters, it is quite painful, I know. Okay, for here try to add something like it will help you, or add something, you know, special to the character. So for example here it grants 75 invisibility percent and ignores target dodge. For an example here we have an accumulation. Okay, I will take this one and we keep going, we are at 30%. Okay, you are going to do what I told you, go further, don't stop anywhere, go for an example here and try to kill them all together. Okay, someone left behind, he didn't came with us. If you get burnt or something, try to switch to someone else. To leave the the debuff goes out from you. Okay, I didn't saw those. So I'm going to use this lady over here. I will tell you right now the way of just finish everything easy. All you have to do is just use the second skill that grants invisibility to her, and you are able to use and kill everyone easily. You keep going. Again on the end, just wait those to finish. And kill everyone together with those small monsters. Try not to die again. Okay, keep going until the end. I think, yeah, here it is Iron Man. Try to stick here. Some of them are not coming, I don't know why. It is some kind of a bug sometimes. But just try not to die. It isn't something difficult to do it, so yeah. All you have to do is avoid those spinners over here. Go further. Further, further, further until the Spider-Mans come. Go behind the Spider-Man. 4 and 5. And that's it. 3-2 has finished also. I'm not trying to speed up because you may have a problem with it. You may stuck somewhere. You will see that there is nothing to be afraid of. It is quite easy. Okay. So here I will use here. As I told you, the invisibility will help you if you are struggling in any kind of small bosses, because those kind of characters are small kind bosses. Look at the damage that she's doing. She's quite a beast. I really like this uniform because from those three, I think it is the most, it is the best one so far. So from here, stay here and let them come to you, because you don't have to fight them there into the poison clouds. Just go here. Okay, we have to change here. All I told you is try to use a Black Widow for the small bosses like him. For the hordes, like a lot of you know, monsters, try Captain America or Iron Man. And if you want to die, if you don't want to die, just try to use Captain America only. The Iron Man is quite half damage dealer and half survivability character. He really gets a lot of boost with his fifth skill. And now we are able to also get a guard effect with this one and also move. So this is quite new and nice one. Let me remember those skills. I think I was going with the shock damage. It doesn't matter. I will go with the fire damage now. The only skills that are really worth to me, it is Black Widow's one, because they will really help you after. Not every skill, but the most of it. So yeah, we are keep going. So if you are quite new to the game, just for you to know, I'm doing a lot of guides. So if you are struggling with something, or if you have any questions for the game that you are not able to understand, or you have a problem to understand what it is, just comment down below. I am able to do any kind of videos you like. As you see over here, the story missions aren't quite, you know, something special into the game, but I really to do guide like videos to help you, because I still see a lot of new guys struggling with the game, and I really want to help you with this one. Okay, so if you have any kind of suggestion for a video to do, don't really just say it. Okay, there is no problem for me to do it. I'm quite, you know, happy to help you with some stuff like that. And don't forget to stay close to the channel, because every 15 days around I'm doing giveaways. And I'll be glad for you to, if you are new, to win one of the codes, because it will help you get some uniforms and progress a little bit further in the deluxe packages and stuff. So yeah, I'm giving the form free, so you don't have to be careful of anything. You're not losing anything. Just stay close to the channel, and you'll get also help, even for the 300 diamonds. As you see over here, it is quite easy. You don't have to be afraid of anything. All you have to do is just keep going. We are already in the half. I know it is quite time consuming. We are already in the 25 minutes. I know it is a lot, but yeah, you have to do it at least once. You may get something good from the from this box that may change your gameplay and stuff. You know, you are able to get premium cards, specific six cards, and it is really worth it, for if you ask me, at least once. I have done it already, but they made some changes before long ago, and I haven't given it a try. I wanted to make a video for you know, the first drop of the day and stuff, so yeah, I wanted to do it with you. And I really liked, as I told you before, the system with the skill selection, because I was hoping for them to bring something new to the game, like the skill selection, but yeah, I don't think it was to be something easy for them to do it for all of those characters we have so far into the game, so yeah, I didn't think that they will do it. So, some of them are not coming, I don't know why. Okay, we did it. It was just one. So, this is one of the boss that it is really a little bit of difficult to say. So that is why I'm going to tell you to use Black Widow here. You see, she did it so easily. And try to use first the skill of the invisibility, because if you get caught, you will die, believe me. So, as I told you again, go at the end of the stage, wait everyone there, and try to kill them all together. There isn't any specific rotation you may use on this one. All of his skills are quite, you know, quite okay. Here it is something you have to do. So you have to kill this one and start the fire. Also here you have to break this one and also start the fire. We have to break three of them. You don't need to kill everyone here, just go and pass the level, okay? The same goes for here. You have to destroy this one, progress further and try to avoid the red ones. And just move to the next stage. You don't have to kill anyone. So from here we start the tips that I told you. All you have to do is avoid the fires and, you know, keep going further and fast. Yeah, it is quite annoying, but all you have to do is just keep forward. That was the stage. There is a character attributes whose we can change. Okay, I will use this one. I really want to go as a Teal for him, and Burn for the Captain America, and I will go with Fire for here, you know, to balance a little bit the debuffs. I don't want anything to be only Fire and yeah. Anything will suit you. The only thing that the only tip that I am giving you here, it is only go for the okay. I don't know why, but he did a lot of damage. I think it was because of the fire damage we did to them. So be careful. I was close to die, so yeah. Try not to do stuff like that. So here we need, again, as I told you, Iron Man, because he does have the energy damage. So the third skill now, the third skill, it is giving us the option to move around with V-pad. That isn't quite, you know, the best option, because as you see over here, we got close to them, and we were at least close to die. So be careful on this one also, and move around and change characters to get the shield effect, and don't let your characters die easily, okay? So go at the end. And just kill them all, and move to the next stage. As I told you, it is quite easy. All you have to do is try to change a character, move to the end, and kill them all together. This is the tip that I'm going to give you. It isn't something special. All you have to do is just go at the end of the stage and kill them all together. So here it is, as those balls appear, all you have to do is change your character so you won't get damage, and all you have to do is just try not to die. So again, after this one, he will try to, this ball over here, all you have to do is going again behind him and let him kill himself. And then kill him instead. Okay, this is what you have to do. Get his energy ball and hit him with it. It will skip this part and be able to hit him, because if you don't, you won't be able to hit him. We are already in the 6-2. If you have any question, comment down below with the story mission that you have problem with, and I may be able to help you with, but I don't think you may have any problem right now with this one. So far it is quite easy, as you see over here. You don't need any specific tips for you to do it. So I think I died from this fire, so be careful of how you use it. So no, I'm not getting any damage from this one. So I don't know what's going on with this one. If you don't want to die, just try to use a second skill and spam the 3 and 4-5. All you have to do is this one. So I'm not getting any damage from the fire below, so I don't know, maybe I got a lot of damage from the minions there. So here we have Ultron. Okay, I had some help from the Black Widow, as you see. And we unlocked the last one, the last skill. Okay, this one works more by tapping the skill, so yeah. I'm going to just have it like this one. I'm going with the shock on this one. It really looks better than this than the other one. And okay. So I don't want her to be so close and the skill looks a little bit slow, so I'm going with this one, the paralyze, and we are already on the 70% and we keep going. As you see over here, the campaign is still a little bit time consuming. We are already in the 36th skill. All you have to do is avoid those guys over here. You don't have to go close to them. Oh my god. Okay. If you go close to them and you won't be able to change this one, just kill them. They are quite easy. All you have to do is just avoid them and go to the next stage. You don't have to fight anyone. You are not going to get any specific kind of reward. So there is no point of you to kill them. It will just consume your time for no point. So again, you are going to the end, bring them all together. When you see them coming all together, try 4 and 5. This is the rotation that kills easily all of the enemies, as I told you. And again, try to stick together all the enemies to easily kill them. Don't worry, you won't die. As you see over here, we already progressing our characters. We begin with 5k HP and now we have 24. That means our characters are leveling up through the stories. So I'm going to kill him with my Iron Man. This will be the best solution for here. And again, we progress further by just going at the end of the map. As you see, the tip it is the same. All you have to do is just stick to the plan and you will finish it in no time. It is not difficult to do. All you have to do is stay close and do the right swaps. And don't let your characters die. So for an example here, you may change and kill him like this. So from here, as you see, we have to kill his bodyguards because we are not able to kill him instead. So we kill all of the surrounded enemies and then we are able to kill Kingpin. We are already in the 75% and as you see, we haven't had any problem. So here we have to destroy those kind of boxes. You don't have to go and fight those robots, so I don't suggest you to do it. Just progress further without killing any of those. If you need, you can just kill this one. I don't think it will let you to take this one. And just pass it, okay? You don't have to kill any of those. Just run and avoid them. Okay, here is a boss. Try to use fire damage to burn it and leave some kind of debuffs so it will die more easily than that. I don't think we will kill him now. Just go behind him and finish also again. The same goes for them now. You don't have to kill them. Progress further. We are invisible and we are not able to die, so... They are not able to see it. I'm just destroying the boxes and progressing further. You don't have to kill them. That's it. Okay. This is a speedrun, don't try to do anything else because it will consume more time than it has already done. So yeah, really we have I think more 4 stages. That was the 7-3 one. And we progress further. 15% left for the campaign version. I think I'm not going to do the normal version of this stage because it will get to be a so big video. So I will tomorrow make another video for the normal version. I will split them to be a very good, you know, video to understand. I don't want to confuse you. So you get the basic, all you have to do is know the those stages and how they work. You know, the ultimate one, it is quite the same, with a little bit more difficulty than this one. So you will understand, those stages are the same like the ultimate. They just have a little bit more difficulty than what are you doing right now. But you have your own character, so it will be easier for you, so don't worry. I'm using energy because the resistance of the physical attack here, it is quite, you know, big as I see, so we need to do it faster. So here, I will stay here to for the cooldown of the skills. They are not moving until I get here. So there is no point of me moving. I will try to... So this is one of the difficult stages on the ultimate mode, because you have to kill all 3 of them, and they're quite difficult to do it. You will see in the next video. So I'm going to do the same. I will wait for the cooldown, because with 1, 5 and 4 I am able to kill all of the enemies with one go, so I don't have to go, you know. So look at this, just look at this. We just needed to use one more skill. We killed the Iron Man with Iron Man. The 8-1 has finished. All we have to, left is 10%. Again, we need to get the control of this one. I have a little tip for you. So as you see over here, he cannot see me, but I am able to hit him. So if you don't know this already, I am able to hit him without him me noticing that I am here. So you can do the same for every single of them. If you don't want to die and you want to kill them, you can go behind them or in the spot that they are not able to see you, and you can just kill them. So we have two of them that we need to acquire, and we have a timer here. This is one of the difficulty stages that I told you. So I'm going to speedrun it a little bit with the Iron Man. I will kill them all easily. And just retrieve the antimatter, the second antimatter. As I told you again, the stages are the same with the ultimate, so be sure to know those because they will help you understand and finish easily. So I'm going to change this one because the cooldown of Fireman is quite, you know, low, and if we need to, I will stick here and I will do the same as I told you again, okay? And the last one, I'm going to use Iron Man to eliminate the rest of the enemies. It is quite difficult because it is also have a timer and a difficult boss to defeat. So be sure not to die here. This is one of the strongest bosses you will find so far. Also here, all you have to do is basically kill everyone and move. I will tell you the same tip that I told you. Go in the last one and try to kill them all together. You don't have to fight one by one. It is quite, you know, difficult. So just try to kill everyone together. It will be easier for you. So. If you are able, if you are going to die, try to swap characters and not let anyone to die, and just get the retrieve the last antimatter. That was it, guys. The A2. One more left until we finish. As I am telling you again, if you have any problem with any specific stage, or just try to watch it from the beginning, or yeah. This is one of the difficult stages, because if you want to get the rewards from the ultimate stage, all of your character has to be alive. And the problem with this one, it is there is an airplane is coming and is killing all of your characters. So here all you have to do is move, you know, just move, okay? It is quite difficult. You won't do it with the first, as I died also because I was stunned. But yeah, this is the only difficult part, the 8-3, because you don't only have those characters to defeat, but you also have some bosses waiting you there. So you have also to fight Loki and Thor. That is quite difficult, believe me. I suggest you to just try to kill Loki first, because he's summoning and freezing you. So the Thor will be easy for you to do it. So here, if you lose anyone, there is no point, and you won't lose anything. You are able to achieve and finish the campaign version. The only problem is from the ultimate version, because you need all of the characters to be alive to get the most of the rewards. We will talk about it when we do it. So that was the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. This is the reward. We are able to get one of those rewards over here. I'm going to see what I got. We are able to do it once a day. I'm not saying that it is really worth it, but yeah, look at this. Those kind of rewards, they really have to just remove them from this box. It got us around 50 minutes, and this is the reward. It doesn't really worth it yet. If they change the reward, it will worth. So that was the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Until the next video, that we will go for the alternate mode, the normal and ultimate, that is quite easier and not time consuming. We will talk about it in the next video. Until the next video, guys, see you again. Bye.